What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video here on Loud and Proud. So it's been quite rainy today. If you guys haven't noticed, like in the background, like the water all over the cars, all over all of the vehicles. Well, anyways, I'm pouring rain all day, so I'm starting this video super late in the afternoon. It's actually almost 7 o'clock in the afternoon. We are going to be focusing on taking off the yellow guard things. If you guys haven't done so yet, follow the LNP_speed Instagram page if you want to get entered to win this car, because that's going to be the first place to find out when the giveaway for this car goes live, which is going to be a completely different website and company and brand altogether. So it's not going to be on the LNP Gear website, and it's not going to be on the Loud and Proud Facebook page and anything else like that. Pretty much just going to be on a completely different platform. So thank you guys for understanding. Hopefully you guys enjoy that. Stay tuned. Let's get this car fired up.
It's been actually pretty like disappointing, because since I bought the car, it's been pouring rain, so I still had to be driving the trucks for the most part. We did do a lot of driving with the Cadillac recently. We went on a road trip, so we took that a couple hundred miles back and forth with the parents and the siblings. But other than that, I've been driving the trucks quite a bit, which is fun. I like driving the 6-speed, you know, it's a good time. First startup in 3 days, okay? 3 days, first start in 3 days. Let's do this.
A lot of questions about this car since I have had it and it's been raining a lot, like in the DMs and stuff. People have asked me, what is it like driving this car in the rain? Because of course the roads are soaking wet, and also I have driven it in the rain a couple of times. It's not bad. Now what you have to consider though is you can't actually use any of the car's performance capabilities in the rain or any damp pavement. Now, if you're just driving the car and you're like, hey, I've considered getting this car and I just want to drive it, is it okay to drive on rainy days? Obviously, yes, you can drive it on rainy days. You just got to be very careful and drive the car as if you're driving your wife's minivan, okay? Or, you know, you get the idea. You just take it easy and drive it, follow the speed limits, don't accelerate fast, and you'll be fine. It won't get crazy, but you just gotta do that. Otherwise, it will get crazy. So I'm gonna take the car over here and I'm gonna actually pull it over into the barn and work on taking off the guards in the front. No more yellow thingies, which we see in the comments a lot. They're gone. Kiss them goodbye. Threw them out. Totally joking. I did not throw them away. I actually kept them because I did get a lot of people that said, oh my gosh, don't throw those things away. They're worth a bunch of money. So we're keeping them in the car because, of course, you guys know we are giving this car away and it's going to be going off to one of you guys. And one of you who win this might want those. And in this video, we're gonna go over the top 5 things that I love and the top 5 things that I hate about this car already within the first week of ownership. Let's start off with the things that we hate so we can end it off on a good note. The first thing that I'm gonna say that I hate about this car is going to be the tire choice from factory. Now, if they are an all-season tire for the everyday driver that's gonna drive it a little bit in the weather, a little bit fast, I guess it's all right, it's fine. But for the most part, if you bought this car to drive it fast, accelerate 0 to 60 all the time, and you just love acceleration, the tire sucks. But luckily for several hundred dollars, you can change them out and get whatever tire you want.
We're gonna step on into the car. So when you get in the cabin of the vehicle, for the most part, there's not a ton to complain about if you're me. I think for the price of the vehicle new and for what it offers in terms of power, performance, and interior and just quality, I think it's a good deal. Something I don't like about this vehicle, I don't know if this is standard on all Hellcats or if it's just the particular optioned out one that I got for a whopping $52,000 sticker. This car does not have, and that's a used sticker by the way, this seat does not have lumbar support or power adjustment. I don't know if that's like a standard thing, but it doesn't have it for $52,000. I just don't think that's acceptable. I feel like it should be like a standard in a car in this day and age.
Now getting to the third thing that I hate about this vehicle, you have to twist your fuel cap out. And then where do you put it? I guess you can kinda like wind it over here and try to hook it. I think there's a little hook here. Yeah. Oh, well, let me see if we can get it. Let's see if we can do this right. Okay. There we go. There we go. Okay, we got it. So you can hook this out of the way. I guess that's kind of cool if you twist it around enough, because of course this is a very bendy, twisty plastic thingy. But I just feel like for a vehicle in this day and age, this is a 2018 model vehicle.
You shouldn't even have to untwist a cap fill thing. It should just be like, you open the gate, you stick the nozzle in, the little flap moves out of the way, you fill it up, you pull it out, it's done. Why am I saying that that should be a standard thing? Well, for when you buy this car new and it's $75,000, I just feel like that should be a standard option.
Hey, look, it's Bugs Bunny coming to pay us a visit. In the interior here, I'm going to explain to you the fourth thing on my list that I absolutely hate about this vehicle. And when I say these things, I'm not saying, oh my gosh, this is just horrible. I can't believe I bought this car and it didn't have these features that I wish it had. Listen, okay, I bought the car because I love the car, because I wanted the car, and I still do overall love the car. And this is a very hard and painful list to come up with of things that I hate, but no adaptive cruise control, okay? And I did just get rid of, well, not get rid of, I gave away a 2019 Limited Ram 3500, and it had adaptive cruise control, which the buttons were, I believe, like right in this location. It's a very nice feature and I wish the car had it. For the money, again, do you need these features? No, but for the money, you just kind of expect some of the basic things that are standard in a lot of vehicles in this day and age.
Last thing I can say that I strongly hate about this car is the big plastic that just goes around the back of the car. Now maybe this is something that to a lot of you seems really stupid, and you know what? It might be something really stupid, but I feel like it would look better paint matched. Maybe that's just me. I get the fact that they're probably thinking, well, that lower portion of the car is just gonna get tons of paint chips, which they're not wrong. If you're shredding tires on a car like this, going down a lot of roads, you're gonna get rock chips flying up. You can see all the dirt down right there, which is exactly where the plastic is. I get that, but you know what? To me, I would rather be paint matched to the color of the car. I understand why they do it. They probably figured it's gonna get tons of damage, especially in a car like this, you know, burnouts and spinning tires and just whatever. They probably figure it's easier to clean it off with a plastic that's just gonna stay like blackish gray regardless of how many rocks and dirt hit it.
List that most of you guys are probably wanting to hear, which is the top five things that I love about this car, and that one's a lot easier to come up with.
I love how big the car is. Now, to a lot of people, this is a very controversial topic. A lot of people think the car's too big, it's ridiculous, it's massive, it's a boat, you should have got something smaller. But this car, I like how big it is. I just do. It gives me tons of room being a coupe that is this big. And I'm not even that tall compared to a lot of guys that prefer these cars over the others, but like this seat gives you so much room and it can go back so far. Now that doesn't give you a back seat, but if you're buying this as a family vehicle, what are you thinking in the first place? If you want a family sedan that's high performance like this, go with a Charger. Now even those are fairly roomy compared to all the other sports cars and muscle cars out there. For this particular vehicle being just under 6 foot, I like a lot of room above my head. I like a lot of room for my legs and to be able to get comfortable and put my seat down, lean back a little. That's just my style. Number two on the list, the retro appearance of the car. This is a true old school, new school car. It's the same look as the original Challenger that had that aggressive, good-looking front end way back, and they still keep it now. Now, did the Challenger have some ugly in-betweens? Yeah, but for the most part, they've stuck to this design now for at least a decade, as far as I can remember. I think it came out in 2009 is when they brought it back, and it stayed true to its roots for a long amount of time now, and I honestly wouldn't mind if it stayed like this forever. The Brembo brakes, absolute must on this car, and they work fantastic. It does kind of get some getting used to. I mean, when you get on these brakes, when you're not used to it and you're used to like driving that, which you need to smash the brakes to stop, it's nothing similar. If you've ever driven one of these cars or any car with these particular brakes on them, this thing stops on a dime, like so fast. It actually gets kind of scary at times because like you'll like start to ease into the brake thinking like you got to take your time to slow down, like in our Cadillac, in any of our trucks, stuff like that. I'm used to truck stuff, you know, and they take a little bit of thinking ahead of time to slow down. This car, if you start hardly brushing against the pedal, it stops. I mean, it's just like, it stops. At least when you're going like under 50 miles an hour, normal everyday driving, this thing will stop you on a dime as soon as you brush against that brake pedal.
For all the taller guys out there, let me explain what I'm talking about with leg room. My legs pretty much just go past the pedals, which I'm saying is a good thing. Gives you lots of room, a lot of options for those guys that are, you know, shorter, taller, the in-between. The seat has a ton of adjustment since the cabin's so big and it doesn't really have a back seat. It does, just not very roomy.
My fourth thing that I like about this car is going to be the interior being driver focused. Now, most of these sports cars and muscle cars you would think should be driver focused, but this car truly is, to me, a more driver focused vehicle, to where the display and all this other stuff is driver focused. It kind of like contours to you. Same with the, you know, box here in the center, just like the way everything is shaped in the interior, it's focused on me, the driver, not necessarily the passenger, kind of like my Cadillac Escalade, where everything is like super center focused because it's for everybody's use and everybody's enjoyment, and you know, it's a whatever. Like, to me, I like that about the interior.
And last but not least, the exhaust. Now, this exhaust is not modified. This is as factory as it gets for this vehicle, but I do love the factory sounding exhaust on this car. There's a lot of muscle cars out there that I'm not so impressed with the factory exhaust, but this one is one of them that I like. Everybody has a preference in what they do and don't like. I'm not saying it's the loudest or it's the quietest or whatever. I'm just saying the sound for the car. I feel like this as a factory exhaust is just perfect, and it's what people are wanting out of this car. Are we gonna make it louder? Potentially, but we're gonna save that for another video. Now, if I'm being honest with you guys, that was a very painful video to make. It was not easy coming up with a list of things that I hated about the vehicle because, let's be honest, I overall really freaking love the car. That's why I bought the car. A few things that if I had to be a super picky person and complain about something, you know, because everybody has stuff they want to complain about, right? So, anyway, if I had to convince myself of something I didn't like about the car, those would be the couple of things that I don't like about it. Now, before we end up this video, let's see if we can call the winner to our 1989 first gen and get him on the phone. His name is Lyle Boone from Sydney, Iowa. We've never had an Iowa winner before, so this is cool. I did not pre-text him and set this up, so this is a first, and he might not answer, but we'll find out.
Hello?
Hey, is this Lyle Boone?
This is him.
What's up, man? This is Malachi with Loud and Proud. How you doing?
I am doing fantastic.
Are you doing better now that you just found out that you won a truck the other day?
Yep, I got the paperwork to him Saturday night, and now you're calling me on Monday.
Sounds awesome. I didn't realize he called you Friday. He just sent me an email this morning that said to give you a call. That's awesome, man. How are you feeling? You believe it yet or not quite?
I believe it even more now that I'm talking to you.
Oh, well, that's good. That's good because it's as real as it gets. I hear you're from Iowa is what he told me. That's correct?
Yes.
Awesome.
Way.
No, this joke's pretty awesome.
He's kind of jealous. He's kind of jealous right now.
Yeah, we've had a lot of second gens. My wife's got two right now. And I love second gens, I love first gens, third gens, fourth gens, I love them all.
Yeah.
The first gens are just like, especially like when you find one like this, which I don't even know how I came across it so easily, like it was just meant to be. Like I was talking to a guy at a lot and I said, hey dude, I am looking for a first gen with low miles. Do you know anybody? And he's like, you know what? Funny you say that, because I just had a guy text me this morning that said, hey, who's that YouTuber kid that buys all your trucks up? He's like, I've got one, I wanna sell him. I'm like, you're kidding me. He's like, yeah, here's his number. I don't know if you'd be interested, but it's a first gen. I'm like, that's what I want. 3 miles from the house I just bought, this guy's got this truck parked in a barn. Couldn't believe it.
Nice.
And I go over there, truck sitting there. He's like, yeah, I haven't driven it in over a year. And then, you know, I drive it like 2-3 weekends a summer to the truck pulls and tow my Chevy over there, my pulling truck. He's like, that's all I do with it. I don't hardly ever drive the thing. I don't want it, you know, rotten out. Like, it's so, so clean. Sounds good. And hey, you can feel free to text this number. I'll send you a text to it, you know, right when I get off the phone. But any updates you get, any questions, any concerns, just shoot me a text, and we want to make sure you have the best experience possible with this, okay?
Yep, thank you.
Sounds good. I appreciate the call. See you soon.
Yep, thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
So that was Lyle Boone from Iowa, Sydney, Iowa, and let's just say this. You got yourself a freaking stud truck, dude. I mean, this thing is nice. So congratulations, first off. That is the first time I talked to him. I'm not going to put all of it in there, but I am going to put some of the clip in there of us talking. Congratulations on the truck. It's amazing. I'm going to show you guys all one more time what truck he won and which truck you guys could win next. So let me show you the truck that he just won, which is this 1989 W350 LE first gen 12 valve Cummins. The thing is freaking mint. So clean. Beautiful truck. Came out of Texas.
55,000 miles on it, and he's going home with this truck in $5,000 cash.
And of course, this is the truck we're giving away currently, Loud and Proud Diesel Giveaway 15, and if you haven't done so yet, you can head on over to lnpgear.com, because every $5 gets you entries towards winning this truck, plus $5,000 cash. It's a 2018 6.7 Cummins with only 11,000 miles on it, and it could be yours coming June 4th. Thank you guys so much for all the support. Everybody who's entered the giveaways, everybody who supported the brand. Lots of huge, crazy stuff coming up soon. We are, of course, launching soon the car giveaway company here to give away muscle cars and sports cars and stuff alike, on top of already doing the truck giveaways every month. And we may also be announcing two more companies that we are launching here very shortly. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. You guys are absolutely awesome. I love you guys. Reagan and I are so thankful. Couldn't do what we do without you guys, and we wholeheartedly mean that. So thank you guys so much. Leave a like on that video. Subscribe if you want to see more. Links are all in the description below. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. We'll get to you. We'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. This is a 2018 6.7 Cummins, and we're giving it away to one of you. Head on over to lnpgear.com, because right now, every $5 you spend gets you 5 entries towards winning this truck, plus $5,000 cash. Don't waste any time, because the giveaway ends on June 4th.